Welcome to Movie Class by Pizza Flicks. Please stay tuned for today's program, but first, some tasty tidbits from your host.
1969 was a fruitful year for the Beatles' favorite musician, Harry Nilsson. His recording of Everybody's Talkin', the theme song for Midnight Cowboy, earned him a gold record and a Grammy for Best Male Vocal. At the dawn of the new decade, Harry took a brief hiatus from album recording. He was now spending more time at his home nestled high up in the Hollywood Hills. One day, hiking through a wooded area with his dog Molly, he looked at the trees and realized they all came to points, and the little branches came to points, and the houses came to a point. And just like that, inspiration struck, and the concept for an animated movie was hatched. With a minuscule budget and less than 8 months production schedule, Oscar winner Fred Wolf single-handedly animated over 28,000 individually drawn frames for the 74-minute film. And now for our feature presentation. On February 2nd, 1971, The Point became the first full-length animated film made for television, debuting as the movie of the week on the ABC network. This telecast featured Dustin Hoffman as narrator and voice of the father, but his contract stipulated his voice could only be used on the initial airing. A very special friend of Harry Nilsson was selected for all home media versions, including this Pizza Flix 50th Anniversary HD edition, produced by my pals at MVD Rewind and the Harry Nilsson Estate.
Can remember when kids used to like to have stories read to them. They'd actually beg their parents, like their fathers, to read these stories.
Oh, Dad, you always start talking about that when I want to watch my
program. It was a very big deal. The fathers would read these exciting stories and sometimes adventure stories to them.
This is my favorite program, Dad.
And the kids would brag to their friends about how their fathers would read these great...
Dad. The other guys get to watch their programs.
Kids used to like their parents. Used to like them to read these marvelous...
Dad.
Now, let's see. Now, here's a story. This is a story...
There'd be monsters?
This is a story a man could actually read to his...
Yeah, okay, Dad.
Monsters. Yeah, sure, monsters. Listen. Once upon a time, a long way from here, and a long way from now, there was a tiny village where everything, the houses and the carts, the bridges and the barns, everything, all had points on them. In fact, it was so full of points that even the people had points. The people, right there on top of their heads. And it didn't seem strange at all, because that's the way life was in the village. That's the way it always had been. And for all anybody knew, that's the way it always would be. As you might have already guessed, the main activity of the village was making points. And needless to say, business was brisk and the competition was competitive.
The people, this is the town where the people all stay. This is the town and these are the people. That's the way they wanted it. That's the way it's going to stay.
And while the farmers kept the villagers' bodies nourished with pointed crops, the artist colony in the community, as in all communities, did their part to keep minds and souls filled with new points to view.
This is the town and these are the people. This is the town where the people all stay. That's the way they want it in. That's the way it's going to stay.
To be, that is the point.
Everything's got 'em. Everything needs one. Couldn't be without one. Everything has one.
This is the town and these are the people. This is the town.
It was a good life, a settled life, and the point was the point of it all. You could look high and you could look low, but you'd never hear any complaints on that count. Well, almost never.
That's the way it's going to stay.
And then one day, a very unusual thing happened in the village. A little baby boy was born. A boy named Oblio. Now, don't get the wrong idea. The being born part wasn't unusual. Little kids were being born all the time in that village. What was unusual was that Oblio, unlike any of the other babies born that day or any other day, had no point. He had no point at all.
Hi, son. Hi, Oblio.
Well, hello there.
Hi, how you doing?
Fine, nice to see you.
Oh, good, what's new?
Same old sixes and sevens.
Really, really.
I
well,
guess
I have
you
to,
heard about them.
Them?
Them, yeah, they had a kid.
Well, that's nice.
Kid's got no point.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm serious. Their kid's a kid who's got no point.
You're putting me on.
Would I lie to you?
Well, I think that is
no
why.
Point.
So you see, Oblio was a kind of involuntary instant celebrity. His uniqueness was, well, something that was noticed around the village. Naturally, his parents couldn't help noticing either.
We have a lot to be thankful for, you know.
He's a healthy little nipper, I'll say that.
And he's happy.
Yeah, I'll bet he'll be a great...
He has a wonderful disposition.
Yeah, but he doesn't have a point.
Maybe he'll grow one.
Yeah.
But he didn't. No. As things turned out, Oblio didn't grow any point at all. But it really wasn't so very noticeable. As a matter of fact, in time, he took to wearing a cap. A pointed cap. His mother made. It kept his head warm, and it did make him look a lot more like all the other ordinary kids in the village. Just about the same time Oblio got his new cap, he also got... You guessed it. The greatest dog in the world.
Wherever we go, everyone knows it's me and my arrow. Me and my arrow. Taking the high road. Wherever we go, everyone knows it's me and my arrow.
And then one day after school, a very serious thing happened.
Hey, let's choose up sides for triangle toss.
I got Harry.
Okay, then I want Fred.
Okay, Richard.
All right, then. I'll take Oblio.
Uh-uh. Not him. He can't play. Ow!
It was the Count's son. And that was the serious thing. You see, the village count was a very powerful man, and frankly, not all that nice a guy. And the way things sometimes work out, a certain amount of that not niceness has rubbed off on his son. Oh, he was liked, but he was not well liked.
How come you said I couldn't play?
'Cause you can't, so beat it.
Always have before, me and Errol.
Hey, look, you're not playing. So just push on.
That's not fair.
Tough. Triangle toss is for people with pointed heads. Toss the triangle.
We know how to play the game.
Then run and catch it on your point.
Aw, everybody knows that.
Yeah, but you got no point, so you can't play.
We can play better than you can.
You what?
I said we can play better than you can.
Hey, wait a minute. You're looking for some real trouble.
And I'll bet you we can beat you at triangle toss, too.
Say that again.
I said, I bet we can beat you at...
Oh, yeah? Well, what do you want to bet?
Huh?
Come on, no point. What do you want to bet?
Bet you anything.
Oblio and the Count's kid are going to duel.
Come on, Oblio,
come on,
fight!
Fight him, fight him! Get him real fun! Come on!
Gonna go. Best two out of three catches. Anything's fair.
Holy cow! Wow!
The only rule is you gotta catch a triangle with your head, or your mutts in your case, Oblio. The first man to catch two triangles wins. Get the idea, Oblio? So long, sucker.
That's okay, Arrow. It's okay. Heck, he's not all that tough.
Players, to your marks!
Stop.
Why?
Come.
Last toss.
Don't forget about Arrow. Arrow was the...
I won't forget Arrow, and I won't forget you either, Roundhead.
Now, what do you want to go say something like that for? Remember, you were the guy who...
Oh, I'll remember, Oblio. And so will you. My father will see to that.
Gee, what is that?
Hey, come on. It's just a dumb old game.
A game, Oblio? Huh. When my dad gets done with you, you'll wish this dumb old game had never been invented.
If it's that important to you, then...
Do you gather my meaning, Oblio?
Predictably enough, when the Count learned of his son's defeat, he was furious. As for the boy himself, as soon as he saw which way the wind was blowing, he just laid low and let his father's evil disposition lead the way.
Would that it were not true! You idiot! You pathetic fool! I groomed you. Oh, how I groomed you. I cultivated you like a rare flower. And for this? Oh, no. By guile and foul deed, I laid the groundwork for you to rule this miserable village one day. And rule you will. I shall not be denied. But as long as that vile little round person, that Oblio, languishes among us, your leadership credibility is shot. We must rid ourselves of that contemptible little twerp once and for all. And that's exactly what I intend to do. Yes, you'll still rule one day, you useless nit, because Oblio is finished. You can bank on that.
Now, the king was a good-natured, harmless old fellow, the kind who had weathered life in a rather middle groove. No great highs, no deep lows. He was a decent but very ordinary man. He was also a very ordinary ruler of other men.
Ah, if it isn't the illustrious...
My king, a word in your ear.
Oh, anything you say, my dear Count. I was just relaxing with a couple of...
Yes, I saw. King, we have a problem.
Oh? Well, that's hard to believe. I thought all systems were go. I mean, I always like to think...
King,
that...
the law of the land has been violated.
Violated? The law of the land? Why, that's impossible.
It is done.
Oh, but there must be some mistake. Why, the law of the land clearly states that everything and everyone must have a point. That purely and simply is the law of the land. Why, you can't violate a law like that in a place like this. Well, just look around.
Look around, my dear king. The law is being violated at this very moment. For the sake of all the decent people, appropriate measures must be taken.
Measures? Oh, my. Measures on a grave charge like this would require my convening... My convening the tribunal.
Exactly.
Oh, my. Now, why do you want to go and create a problem like that?
Oh, that's no problem, King. That's a solution. The problem was created when the law was violated. In point of fact, by that little round-headed twit, Oblio.
Oblio? Oblio? But I know him. Why, he's a nice little boy. Well, I know his parents. Why, it was my understanding that this Oblio was developing into a pretty decent little triangle toss player.
So I gather. He's also round, which, as you yourself know, is in direct violation of the law. You may as well face it, my dear king. This Oblio is literally an outlaw.
Oh, but that's incredible. Wait a minute. He wears a nicely pointed hat. That should count for something, shouldn't it?
No way, my king.
We must convene a tribunal, a public tribunal, and so we shall. And then, after all the niceties are looked after, this Oblio will be neatly banished forever.
A tribunal? Oh, no. And for Oblio? Why, isn't there any other way?
The law is the law, King. You cannot fight that.
The law is the law. I never looked at it quite like that. Very well. A tribunal it is. But I warn you, Count, I won't have the boy railroaded.
Railroaded?
A turn of phrase, Count.
Well, the Count was having a marvelous time. No matter how rotten he may have been ethically and spiritually and every other way, as a prosecutor he was good. And as a stand-up performer he was even better. The way it all worked out, poor little Oblio never had a chance.
And so, noble king and good gentlemen of the tribunal, I would only remind you that this law, so cherished a part of our tradition, was not enacted, nor is it being applied, for purposes of base persecution or cruel harassment. Oh, good gracious, no. The law was created to preserve and protect the sanctity, the integrity, the purity of our heretofore unsullied life mode. And so it is that this freak, this viper, Oblio, by his very existence here in our realm, only serves to...
Oh, my dear, isn't the Count absolutely too much?
Well, I'm sure he's very good, but all the same, I can't help feeling sorry for little Oblio. After all, he is...
Oh, I just don't see how you could say that. That's so sentimental. Well, sure, he's little, but the law's still the law. And where would we be, my dear, if...
But to just sit here while those old men complacently let the little...
Listen, neither one of us was born yesterday. And we both know if we let one of Oblio's kind stay, oh, before long the whole village will be crawling with...
My dear Count, isn't there some way or other little Oblio could just sort of stick around? I mean, if he promised to keep his hat on all the time and didn't ever...
In this stead, my king, the law is most explicit. We all agree that there has been a violation of law. The violator is right here in our midst. We can see that. That is, as the fellow says, beyond question.
Would it help if I promised to never, ever play triangle toss again? I mean, if that's what you're mad about, Count, I could...
No, gentlemen. The only question remaining is one of penalty. Here again, the law is crystal clear. For such a grave breach, banishment. That is the order of the day.
Yeah, the Count's really pulling the chain on that weird little old...
Oh, how can you joke about such a thing? I think a terrible thing's happening. And Oblio's such a lovely little boy.
Yeah.
You know, he's polite and he's well-mannered. And
he may be, but would you want your daughter to marry...
Oh, you're baiting me. You're deliberately baiting me. I will not be subject.
Gentlemen, it remains beyond question that Oblio, by his mere rounded existence, stands in violation of the law. Here our duty is clear. But we would ill be serving the law to overlook an entirely new facet of the case. In point of fact, Oblio was both aided and abetted by his flea-bitten canine.
Hey, please, don't do anything to Arrow.
Gentlemen, I charge this dog, Arrow, with criminal conspiracy.
Honest, Arrow's innocent. I did it all myself. I did it. Arrow wasn't even...
He is as guilty as Oblio himself. But what's more repellent about him, he's a disgrace to everything. Point it. No, gentlemen, this Arrow is not only a conspirator. He is also a traitor. And he, too, must be banished.
Hey. How they going?
Not bad.
Say, what's the latest?
Oh, you know.
Wild trial, huh?
Well, if you've seen one, you...
What about this conspiracy business with Sparrow?
Arrow.
Right.
It could be a toughie.
No, you really think so?
Conspiracy's no laughing matter.
Hard way to go, is it?
Could be for someone like Arrow.
You know, he doesn't look like the conspiratorial type, though.
Yeah, he's got a record long as his tail.
That long, huh?
Yeah. Chasing, night barking. They'll throw the book at him.
Adios, Arrow.
That's it.
And so, it is my deeply unpleasant task to declare that this tribunal finds the boy Oblio guilty of living within our midst without a point. For this grave violation of law, he is from this day forward banished to the pointless forest. I might just parenthetically add, as our good count so aptly put it, the law is the law. And as all of you know, without the law, why there would be no lawyers. And without lawyers, well, it just goes on and on.
Deal with the dog, my lord.
Yes, the dog. Well, Arrow, I must send you over to boy. Involuntary conspiracy.
Take them away.
Now, dear, I know how you hate to wear undershirts, but we don't know what the weather will be like, and this is a dangerous time of year for colds, so...
Sure, Mom. Great. I'll wear them. So will Arrow. Don't cry, Mom.
Well, I just don't want you to take a chill, little Oblio.
It's just about time, dear. You all set, O? Now, son, I hope you realize, I hope you understand how distressing this is for your mother and me. Well, I just wish there were some way. Don't get me wrong, I believe in obeying the law and everything. Anything else would be anarchy, but still I wish there were some way this particular law could be,
Sure, Dad. I understand.
Well, I just wanted you to know this, Oblio.
Good luck, Oblio. Good luck, Arrow.
And don't blame the king too much, son. He just did what he had to do. After all, it's his job. And, frankly, I wish there never was such a law in the first place. And now that it's been used, it seems, it really seems unfair.
How come nobody ever did anything about it before, Dad?
Well, it just never came up before, son.
Oblio? Here, Oblio. Here's a candy bar for you. For the road.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Candyman.
And this is for Arrow.
Hang in there, Oblio!
Stay loose, Ob.
They're seeing you, Oblio.
Oblio, old man, here's a little something for you, just in case you need some change. You know, you can never tell when you might need a couple of bucks to,
Thanks, Dad.
Take good care of yourself, dear little Oblio, and eat well, and write to us when you can. It doesn't have to be anything long. Just a card to say you're fine. Will you do that for your poor mommy, Oblio?
Sure, Mom. Don't worry. We'll be okay, right, Arrow? Come on, boy. Let's go.
Go get him, Oblio.
Stay in there, pile driver.
Go straight, Ob. You got it wired.
Good luck, kid.
Goodbye, Oblio. Goodbye, son.
Goodbye, my little baby.
Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Come on, Arrow, let's go.
Sit beside the breakfast table. Think about your troubles. Pour yourself a cup of tea, then think about the bubbles. You can take your teardrops and drop them in a teacup. Take them down to the riverside and throw them over the side to be swept up by a current. Then taken to the ocean to be eaten by some fishes. Who were eaten by some fishes and swallowed by a whale who grew so old he decomposed you. Do, do. He died and left his body to the when a body decomposes, the basic elements are given back to the ocean, and the sea does what it ought to. Tastes just like a teardrop, and it comes out from a faucet
into a teapot,
which is just about to bubble.
Now you tell me, is this a story, or is...
Yeah, Dad, sure. It's an okay story. It's sort of...
Okay? Are you kidding me? Just okay? Come on, it's more than...
Oh, it's good. It's...
Now what about the Count, eh? Talk about your oppressive villains.
I like the kid Oblio, and his dog. I think he's a great-looking dog. He reminds me...
Oh, yeah, he's a great-looking... Oh, sure. I get it. Youth, imagination, the view from the mind's eye. You've got a creative little head on your shoulders there, son.
Huh?
I'll bet you can just picture this little Oblio and his dog right now.
Me and my arrow.
On and on they went. After a while, they even stopped looking back, the village having long since faded in the distance. And the truth of the matter is, they were really a lot more excited about what lay ahead of them than what they had left behind. And who wouldn't be? No one had ever been to the Pointless Forest. Yet now, Oblio and Arrow were going.
Hey, Arrow, you think there'll be monsters? I'd be just as happy if there weren't any monsters. But either way, no matter what happens, we gotta stick close together. Because we're really a team now. Hey, you know what I hope? I hope. Oops. Arrow! Can this be the Pointless Forest? How can it be? It's gotta be. But if it is, how come everything's got a point? The leaves are pointed, the branches and twigs are too. Everything. Well, this is it, Arrow. This is the beginning of the place we were banished to. There's just one thing I don't understand. How are we supposed to get through this stuff to get in there? It's so thick. It's like a jungle. Good boy, Arrow. Good boy. Now just follow me. No, I'll follow you. No, we'll go together. That's a plan. We'll go together. And whatever you do, don't leave me, Arrow.
Oblio and Arrow had just barely set out on the road into the Pointless Forest when all of a sudden...
Arrow, look, a man. A pointed man. Excuse me, sir. We thought this was the Pointless Forest.
Quite right, my boy.
Well noted.
This is the place indeed.
By name,
the Pointless Forest.
But what is a pointed man doing in the Pointless Forest?
Listen to the lad.
Me pointed?
That's too funny.
You know, he's funny.
Me, a pointed man?
This youth amuses me.
But, sir, you're pointing right now, more than any...
My boy, I'm not the pointed man you think I am.
I can point in every direction, sure.
Any fool can do the same.
But...
A point in every direction?
Is the same as no point at all.
Oh, would you argue the point?
I wouldn't.
Not on a bet.
It never entered my mind.
Suddenly, Oblio and Arrow were all alone in the Pointless Forest. At first, everything seemed quiet, peaceful. Oblio thought about the pointed man and wondered what his friends in the village would have said if only they knew that he had seen and talked to such a rare person. Then Oblio noticed how quiet it was. Arrow noticed too. It was very quiet. Then little by little, Oblio began to feel lonely.
You know, Arrow, I was just thinking. I mean about that pointed man. I don't know. I think there's something a little funny about that man.
I mean, he's pointed. Heck, he's always pointing. Then he says he isn't a... Arrow? Hey, Arrow, I think I'm scared. Hey, now what do you want to go and growl like that for? Especially when I told you I'm... What is it, boy? Huh?
Wow! Giant feet! Run, Arrow! Run for your life!
I believe it was E flat, double style, extra fortissimo, don't you know it?
Huh?
Say, what's happening with you boys? You been goofing with the bees?
Gosh, who are you?
It's me, the Rock Man.
I never saw a Rock Man before.
Well, the stone folks are everywhere. Just open your eyes and look around you.
You mean there are more of you?
Naturally, baby. There's a whole family of us rock folk.
Will, I was wondering if this is still the pointless forest.
Listen, Jack, there ain't nothing pointless about this gig. Just look around yourself. The birds singing sweet love song to the trees, and squirrel doing crazy takes all over the place. Mother Nature, she watching over the whole scene. And dig me, taking it all in.
Yeah, but...
It's the here and now that I'm talking about. The smell of sweet life in the air. It's the warm feel of the sun and the beat of the music. Just digging yourself.
But I can't see the...
Well, you see what you want to see. Tell me, did you ever see, dinosaur?
No.
Well, did you ever see pterodactyl?
No.
Well, did you ever want to see a pterodactyl?
I guess not.
Well, that's it. You see what you want to see, and you hear what you want to hear.
Gosh, Mr. Stoneman.
It's a rock man, Jim. You gotta keep yourself in a historical perspective.
I mean Mr. Rockman. Well, you see, you're so round and everything.
Come on, boy. Out with it. Don't get yourself all racked up and jammed. You got a question? Lay it on me, but let it out easy.
It's just that everything's been happening so fast. We were banished, and then those bees.
I can dig it, I can dig it. Look, let me hip you to reality.
I'd really rather know if this is still the pointless forest.
Now there you go again. Pointless. That's the central issue, what I'm putting down for you cats.
Huh?
You gotta open your mind as well as your eyes. But first, you gotta get it together. You know, be cool. Dig yourself. Get the message? Now, here's the lick. You don't have to have a point to have a point, dig? Now, I fear you've been getting some negative vibration from someplace. You gotta collect yourself. Be cool. Be steady as a rock.
Steady as a rock?
That's right. Being a rock is a very heavy life. Us rock folks are impervious to heat. We stay cool. We're insusceptible to water. And that's cool, too.
But when it rains, isn't it true that even stones...
Now there you go again, you tensing up. Rain, oh yeah, sure, maybe rain turn a tree to a waterlog. Sometimes rain makes a river lose its flood control. But a rock in the rain is just cool, very cool.
Boy, I never realized that rocks and stones were so...
All you gotta do is open your mind along with your eyes. Now you got a long road, son, so... You remember what I say, okay?
Oh, I will, Mr. Rockman, I will.
Play it easy. And remember, as you make it through this forest, ain't necessary to possess a point, to have yourself a point.
I'll remember that.
Yeah, well, I think I'm gonna take myself a short nod. You will by this way again, just fall in. I'm only a stone's throw.
Professor Rockman to explain that to us. And I'll tell you something else. I'll bet it's not everybody who gets to talk to rock folks. You know, he really was a nice guy.
Ah, my good lad.
I've been rolling right along, I see.
Arrow, it's the pointed man again. Hello, sir.
What's this? Still talking of points, my boy?
The youth's obsessed.
I'll make a point of noting that.
Ah, your point. Nice shot.
I love game.
We've just met a man who's made of stone.
Oh, yes.
Excellent fellow.
Splendid chap.
All you gotta do is relax.
You gotta open your mind.
That's cool.
He's a nice man. He knows a lot. And he's generous. And
he gave you gifts?
A little remembrance, maybe?
Perhaps a small memento?
No. He told me things. He's interesting to talk to.
Ah, completely pointless, my boy.
In a word, abstract.
To put it bluntly, Sonny Bob, pointless. All pointless.
That is to say, no point.
The big zero, as they say.
Hey, wait for us, please.
Sometimes you never know how really happy you are to see a person until after he's gone. That's pretty much the way Oblio felt when he realized the man who was always pointing had just up and disappeared.
Jiminy, Arrow. That was a close call. You gotta watch your step. That hole could be... Holy cow! There's no bottom to the thing. Arrow, you could have been... Arrow. Gosh, hi, Arrow. Hello? Hello? Hello?
A dogged trooper, that boy.
To say nothing of that boy's dog.
They pursue in pointless pursuit.
Their pursuit is pointless.
Good boy, Arrow. You found him. Hi, sir. We've been looking all over for you.
What a pleasure.
What a splendid surprise.
Thought you might be holed up somewhere.
We were trying to catch up with you, and then we found this gigantic hole. It was big and dark and... and scary.
And frankly, quite pointless.
No, we learned a lot. I know Arrow did, and so did I. Old Arrow found out that he's really got a...
Careful, Sonny. Don't get in over your head.
It wouldn't do to bury yourself intellectually.
Point of fact, it never pays to submerge too deeply.
What is it, Arrow? He must hear something.
Why, of course
he hears something.
Obvious.
Come on, boy. What's wrong, huh? What is it, Arrow? It seems like he's trying to... Gone again. Hey, Arrow! Hey, wait a minute, boy! Arrow! Arrow! Come back, Arrow! Wait for me! Hey, Arrow! Hey, wait a minute, boy! Arrow! Arrow! Why did you have to go on? Hey, Arrow! That sounds like singing. That is singing. Excuse me, but who are you, ladies?
You say?
Hmm? Oh, you. I'm sorry, I didn't know.
How's that?
Out with it, boy.
Get it off your chest.
The ladies. Those three fat ladies. The way they danced and played and...
Ah, yes. Quite pointless.
Wouldn't you say?
Fat?
Round.
Pointless.
Get it?
Oh, no. They do have a point. It's laughter and merriment and making each other happy.
Oh, really?
That's an interesting misconception.
But then I'm sure you'll agree.
Hey, you! Are you kidding? For crying out loud, will you get out of there? Not there either. For the love of Morris, what are you trying to do? You're trying to destroy me? Will you back off? What is this? Will you stop fooling with that mutt and get away from those leaves, you pathetic nincompoop?
I'm terribly sorry, sir. I didn't see you, and I didn't realize...
All right already. As it happens, those are Sunday in the sunset leaves. A golden veneer and very rare. And you look like you were just gonna plow right...
Gosh, I'm sorry. I never...
You know, leaves like that don't just grow on trees or something.
I really am sorry. We thought we were just in the regular pointless forest. This is still the pointless forest, isn't it?
Pointless? Pointless? Just look at those leaves. Each one more pointed than the last. I tell you, this is the most pointed collection of...
Then you're a collector. Golly, a leaf collector.
A collector? What, are you joking or something? Who ever heard of a grown man going around collecting leaves? Oh, that's weird. What am I supposed to do, put them in a scrapbook?
Well, I just thought...
No, you didn't think. We're in business here. Business! This isn't some game we're playing, young man. This is the real thing, and we gotta move.
Jiminy, the leaf business. I didn't know people sold leaves. Well, I always thought...
You thought. You thought. Yeah, and while you're thinking, I'm losing time. Besides, I will do all the thinking around here.
Gosh, sir.
Listen, I can't talk now, young man. It's go for broke time from here on in. This is the time of year we put together our whole fall line.
I'm afraid I don't know what a fall line is.
It's the magic of the sorcerer and the excitement of the artist at the moment of creation. It's when we turn green leaves into greenbacks, when the gold on those trees becomes gold in our pockets.
You mean you're gathering all of these leaves for...
Gathering? Gathering? I'm not a gatherer, Sonny. I'm a manufacturer. And when you're in the manufacturing game, timing is everything. You make it or break it on timing. Sure, design counts, quality counts, maximizing total production potential, that counts. They all count, but without good old timing, it's so long, Charlie.
But with leaves, how do you know if...
Take the fall season. If I brought it out in July, it's forget it. It's a disaster. Timing, it's all timing. All right, let me ask you something.
Anything you want.
Ah, you're interested. I like that. And you're sharp. I need people who are sharp. Sure, I can get help, but good help, that's something else again. Question, is the world ready for a tweed leaf? Stop and think.
To tell you the truth, I just don't know.
I like that. You're honest. Yes, timing and honesty, that's the name of the game. All right, let's face it. This is a business, just like any other business. Anyone can learn a business, right? But honesty, you either got it or you ain't got it. Why are you frowning? What's bothering you?
Excuse me, sir, but don't leaves just make themselves naturally without any...
Oh, my boy, you got a lot to learn. Tell me, what nationality are you?
Well, sir, I'm from the Pointed Village.
That's funny. You don't look pointed.
As it works out, I'm not. But my parents are.
It's all right. Don't give it a second thought, my boy. I don't care what a man's faith, creed, or color is. The only thing that matters to me is whether or not he can produce. Well, what do you say?
About what?
Are you in or not? I'm offering you a chance to get into the leaf game.
But what can I do?
Naturally, you'll have to start on the forest floor and work your way up. And I'll tell you one thing, I don't ever want to see you or that clown of a dog of yours standing around on the product.
Oh, we wouldn't. You can be sure of that.
Great opportunity for you, my boy. Can open doors for you, big doors. Seasonal? Yes, we're seasonal. Summer, winter, spring, fall. You and your dog will work like dogs. Rest? You'll rest during the fifth season. And there isn't any fifth season. But there are rewards. It's exciting, challenging work manufacturing leaves.
But that's just it, sir. I don't want to seem ungrateful, but I don't see how Arrow and I could...
It's the simplest thing in the world, my boy. You just plant your roots right here with me, and by next season you'll...
But we don't have any roots to plant. We aren't...
No roots? No roots? Oh, well, that just about tears it, doesn't it? Oh, it's too bad, too. You could have been up there with the best of them, kid. Sunday in the sunset, leaf of gold, you name it, you could have had everything. And together we would have been unstoppable. We could have given them those tweed leaves. Oh, it would have been beautiful, beautiful.
Boy, it sure sounds like it could have been, but something's kind of confusing me.
Well, you just name it, son. You can't get answers in this world if you don't ask questions.
It's just that. I know there's a point to every leaf, but what's the point to all the leaves? Your leaves.
That confuses you, doesn't it? Well, all of mankind is confused. You work, you struggle, you fight to survive. Little by little, you make something, you get ahead, and then one day you look, you see you got something, and I mean really something.
But what's the...
Can't talk now, young man. Got a time problem that won't quit. Yes, timing. Ha ha. Timing, that's the name of the game.
No, Arrow, let's go around. Who knows? These could belong to the leaf man, too. And you know how he is about stepping on his product.
That's quite right, my boy.
Watch your step.
Whatever you do, don't bring a leaf to grief.
Its branch might blanch.
Worse yet, its trunk might go kerplunk.
Oh, Mr. Pointed Man, you should have been with us. We met a very important businessman.
Was he out raking leaves, perhaps?
This brilliant industrialist.
This extraordinary tycoon.
Ho, ho, ho. My good lad, your manufacturer is a bust.
His product is so ununique
as to be completely pointless.
Oh, no. He's a very industrious industrialist, and he never rests, and he always...
My boy, he's spinning his wheels.
To put it concisely, his work is futile.
In a matter of speaking, it's pointless.
That can't be. He told me that...
Sunday in the sunset.
Today tweed, tomorrow herringbone.
The man's a lunatic.
He's mad.
Clearly a case of dementia.
But he was nice. He offered me a chance to...
He's a king among men.
He's a prince of a fellow.
I pass.
Parajax, ace high.
In sum, my good lad, pointless. Pointless.
I don't see how you can keep saying that about everybody. I mean, just because you don't...
Careful, boy. Don't jump to any rash conclusions.
You could land on thin ice.
And come up all wet.
If you follow the image I've drawn.
That could be a chilling experience. Yeah.
Little by little, Oblio was learning a good deal about the pointless forest and its unusual residents. But unfortunately for him, and Arrow too, his knowledge couldn't possibly help him anticipate what was hovering directly above. No, Oblio had absolutely no way of knowing what was in the wind.
A lot more. It's treetops and horizons and hills and meadows and everything. Man, this is great.
You know something? This bird could mean real trouble now.
Aw, Dad, they'll be okay.
Ah, sure, that's easy for you to say.
What can an old bird do?
Well, you're not up there, hanging on for dear life.
Ah, come on, Dad. You know he's not going to let him drop.
Well, I don't know that. I don't know that. And you don't either. You don't know how dependable he is. Why, he could very easily...
Nah, Dad, not a bird that size.
A bird what size?
Well, didn't you mention something about a huge bird? I thought you said...
You know, when I was a kid, my dad read to me, and I listened. And I listened closely. I didn't go around interpreting things.
Yeah, okay, Dad.
I didn't jump to conclusions.
That's good, Dad.
I don't know what's happening to kids nowadays. You give them everything. You offer to read to them. I don't know. I just don't know.
And suddenly, the strangest things are happening. I hope it's not the last time. Last time I had a drink or two an hour or so ago. It made me think of you, and now I know it's not the last time. Last time. Flying high up in the sky, I wonder why. I think I'm gonna fall. I think I'm gonna fall. Oops. But there I go again. I'm up again. There I go again. I hope this isn't all. La 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 la. for that. I hope it's not the last time.
Back to Earth again, Errol. We made it safe and sound.
As Oblio circled the mammoth egg, he was overcome with a strange sensation. He looked at the egg very closely, examining it again and again, but each time his conclusions were exactly the same.
Hey, this is weird. Just when I was sort of starting to think that maybe this pointless forest isn't pointless at all, we come across something that really is pointless. At least it sure looks like it is.
You see, after each one of his adventures in the forest, Oblio always found himself left with a sort of free-floating feeling that there was some sort of point to what he had experienced, even though it had happened in a pointless forest.
A point! Errol, I was right in the first place. Even a thing like this, a thing that looks like it's all around, has some sort of point. Hi, little fella. I mean, big fella. Are you all right? Oh, well, I'm Oblio. And this guy right here's my dog. His name's Arrow. What? Are you saying what? Well, what happened is you just got hatched. You're born now. But don't worry. It happens to everybody. You'll be okay. Where? Is he saying where, Arrow? That's a little harder. You see, the name of this place is the Pointless Forest. That's where we are, all right. But I'll tell you something. I'm starting to think that instead of being pointless, this forest is full of points. Take you, for instance. Sure, you've got a pointed beak, but that's just a point. Anyone can see that. Your real point, well, that's something else again. Why? That's the hardest one to answer. That's what I always want to know. Why? And that's the question everyone always asks.
Splendid idea, my boy.
I'd like mine over easy.
With a side order of bacon, if you please.
Very crisp and coffee. The old mocha jabba.
I had a hunch you'd be serving brunch.
And perhaps an apricot Danish.
Oh, Mr. Pointed Man, I'm glad you're here. But how come that nice new bird's mother took him away like that? We were just talking about the why of everything. Why this, why that? And then, just when I was thinking that...
Now, there you go again.
You're thinking.
That's very destructive, my lad.
Most destructive indeed.
If a person does enough thinking...
A certain amount of knowledge is sure to follow.
The result, Sonny Bob...
Could be a life of misery.
But I can't help it. I haven't been trying to think. Things just sort of start popping up in my mind. They occur to me out of...
Thoughts just start popping up into your mind.
Ideas form without any effort on your part?
You find that concepts simply conceptualize?
Well, yes.
That's grim.
It started way back when I met the Rock Man.
It's a disaster.
And it just kept on happening.
Mayday! It's a complete mayday!
I was hoping maybe you could help me figure out just exactly...
There's really nothing more that I can do.
You're out of my hands.
I tried to help you, boy.
Tried to show you the pointlessness of it all.
But you wouldn't listen.
Sir, I hope you don't think I'm ungrateful.
You had to go digging around, didn't you?
You had to let thoughts slip into your head.
You're lost, lad, lost.
The kid blew it.
Had everything going for him and he blew it.
The fact is, my boy, that is, under the circumstances...
There's no place in the pointless forest for you.
But where'll I go? What'll I do? I can't go home again. The Count had me banished.
Ta-ta!
Jolly bye.
Ciao, Bucky, ciao.
Golly, gone again. I wonder where he goes when he does that.
Vanishing point, old man.
Correct. The vanishing point.
Just another one of the facilities.
Well, adieu.
Fare thee well.
You take care of yourself, you hear?
Come on, sir.
Oblio watched as the pointed man disappeared. But unlike all the other times, he was not especially overwhelmed by what he saw.
I think he's really gone this time, Arrow. Arrow? Arrow? Here, boy. Arrow? I hear you, boy. Where are you? He's gone. Stay where you are, Errol. Don't move. I'll find you. I know I will. Good boy, Errol. Come on, boy. You're all right now. Come on, Errol.
It had been a full day for the two travelers, a very full day. For Oblio, it had been one adventure after another. Of course, it had been pretty adventurous for Arrow, too.
That vanishing point, it only made it so I couldn't see. It didn't make it so you weren't really there. I'm starting to think that the pointed man, nice as he was really about the only pointless person we've met in this whole pointless forest. Sure, he did an awful lot of talking, and it all sounded very fine, almost like the count in a way. And after all, what's such a big deal about having a point on your head? Nothing against you, Arrow. You're great. But I sort of think what's in your head is a lot more important. It sure gets dark fast, doesn't it?
Are you sleeping? Can you hear me? Do you know if I am by your side? Does it matter if you hear me? When the morning comes, I'll be there by your side. And in the morning, she may be telling me goodbye, la 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 la. And in the evening, if we pray, girl, I'm wondering why, yeah, yeah, I'm wondering why, yeah, 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 yeah. There was a time we had a time, there was a time we had a time. There was a time, there was a time when you were mine. Time, oh what a time. There was a time, there was a time when you were mine. And in the evening, if we go out, nighttime will find us at the show. La 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 la. Oh, we may decide to stay inside. You never know, you never, never know. You never know, you never know.
Great little guy.
I'm worried about him.
That little guy? Nah, he'll do great out there.
But he's so young.
Yeah, but he's sharp. He's sharp. He's young, but he's sharp.
Oh, we should have never let them send him away.
Yeah. Well, go tell the Count that. I mean, it was the law, dear.
Oh, it's a bad law.
Well, good law, bad law. What difference does it make? It's the law.
It makes all the difference. A good law would have never sent my Oblio away. Never.
Dear, the law is the law.
Well, you should have challenged it.
What? I should have challenged it?
We all should have.
Law? I mean, but the Count came right out and said...
Oh, the Count, the Count. What about my Oblio?
Well, look, I mean, I'm just one man. I
we should have all stood up. Even the king seemed like he was against
them. Well, maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. Maybe we should have tried.
Oh, he's so young.
What, the king?
My little Oblio.
Oblio! Oblio! It's Oblio! Hey, it's Oblio! Come back and come to our town now! Hold our town! Hold our town! Oblio! 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 It's coming back! Welcome home, Oblio!
We're glad you're back, Oblio.
You tell him, old. Break it down for him.
Come by the shop, Oblio. I have some butterballs for you. Round. Completely round. There he is! There's Oblio!
My baby. My Oblio.
Well, hi, son. Hi, Oblio.
On to the palace! To the king!
Your Majesty! Your Majesty! There's a mob at the palace gate.
Mob? Well, why, that's pretty hard to believe.
Well, it's true. You know what a mob is. Shall I call out the palace guard?
Well, that does seem a bit excessive, doesn't it?
Well, what do you suggest? Send out a pastry tray and let them eat cake?
Well, that's never worked before. Tell me, what does your intelligence agency make of it?
Nothing yet, nothing. They're still trying to infiltrate the crowd. But I'll tell you one thing. According to my son, it's all for that kid, that twerpy, round-headed Oblio.
Oblio? You mean little Oblio, who we...
Yes, my son claims he's come back.
Really? Oblio? Little Oblio is back?
This is gravely serious, my dear king.
Yes, it is. You know something, Count? You may have misread the will of the people in that Oblio case. An unruly mob, eh? Well, isn't that just the limit?
Demand silence! Can't a man get a little peace and quiet in his own? Say, what are you doing back? This little runt is an outlaw. You're an outlaw, child. You are banished to the pointless forest.
And I went to the pointless forest. In fact, I...
Nonsense! Sheer, irrevocable nonsense. I'll have you in chains for this. Arrest this little...
Hold it, Count. The boy was saying something.
Yeah, right on. Break it down for him, Obi.
Yes, right on, Obi.
Well, sir, we did go to the pointless forest, Arrow and I. All through it, in fact. And you know something? It isn't pointless at all.
It's not?
What? What? Not pointless? Madness! That's madness! Sheer madness!
Will you be quiet, Count? I want to hear Oblio. Now, Oblio, you were saying?
Well, the fact is, sir, that just about everything we ran into had a point to it. The leaves, the trees, everything.
Oh, I see, Obi. Well, I can't really argue that one with you, but what about yourself, son?
Well, sir, I figure if everything has a point, then I must have one, too.
He has a point there!
Villainy! Treason! Public naughtiness! I will not stand by while this pointless person tries to undo the law of the land. My dear and loyal friends, if he had a point, he'd have one. Impossible.
And so it was that Oblio and Arrow returned safely from their travels, only a little older, but certainly a good deal wiser. As for the pointed village, well, the way things worked out, it was a much better place to live after Oblio's return. True, the people didn't have their once-cherished points right there on top of their heads, but that didn't matter so much anymore. People just started assuming that every man had some kind of a point, whether it shows or not. The end. Now that's a story, son. I mean, is that a story, or...
Yeah, Dad. It was a good story, really.
Good,
Good. It was great. Great story.
Sure, Dad, it was.
I mean, it had everything. Right there, adventure, a little comedy, funny scene or two. There was a lesson. You caught the lesson, didn't you?
Right, Dad, I caught it.
Well, what do you think it was?
Well, just because somebody doesn't have what other people have doesn't mean that, you know, they have to be turned out of the kingdom or something.
Mm, yes.
Dad?
Oh, what is it, son?
Thanks for reading me the story.
You're welcome, son.
Are you sleeping? Can you hear me? Do you know if I am by your side? Does it matter if you hear me? When the morning comes, I'll be there by your side. Thank you.